fight it anymore. Not on my own. Where are you, Mother? I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother. To go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimbal was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
Hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help. A little hope.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Rain. But Rain does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rain's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rain's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature, a dragon.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't turn back. Don't open the
door. What's happening?
Get back. A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it.
She can't make it.
The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Sinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
Where are you going, Sarah?
end. She'll have to go in.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
I told her to come out.
Don't.
She has to do it.
She'll come out.
She can do it.
She can't do it.
The light's gone out. Run. Run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is in.
Thank you.
claim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Reyn would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Reyn reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Reyn go in search of Fafnir. The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Sigurd.
sense. She can sense it. She needs to pick it. There.
Where?
No, beast. Something else is coming. Alert. Get your torch up. What was that? No.
Get ready. Get ready.
There. Get ready.
And...